Assalamu alaikum. Welcome back, children, for the class 8 standard. And today we are going to learn a topic in geography, that is the Earth, our living planet. So here, you children, you have learned this topic from your grade 1, 2, 3. Yes. So this is not a new topic to you. So we are going to learn a complete structure of the Earth. Then afterwards, indices here, the globe intersecting the lines, that is the latitude and longitude, local time, standard time, international data lines. So these all we are going to study in this topic. So now, as we are living on the Earth, so do you know the how many planets are there? Can you name them? Yes, there are 8 planets. That is Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. So these are the 8 planets. Now when we come to know about these planets here, Mercury, Venus, Earth. So what's the, so Earth in the sense, Earth is the third planet from the sun. So this Earth is a home for all animals. In the sense here, it is a home for all the features like plants, animals, human beings. So we all survive our life on land. And this Earth is gifted by Almighty God. So we can see the nature beauty. What other things can we see on the Earth? In the sense here, plants, herbs, shrubs, mountains, then plateaus, then valley, streams. So these all we see in nature, different type of rocks, soils, everything we see. So we survive our life on Earth. So we are going to study this topic. And here, since it is a home for all forms of like plants, animals and human beings, why? Because it's suitable distance from the sun, the range of temperature, life, supporting gases, atmosphere and water cycle. So only it is a home. So what are the names, title for the Earth? Can you? Yes. So here the different names for the Earth, like our Earth is called by many names. Living planet, unique planet, watery planet and blue planet. Okay, these are the names, title for Earth. So now after studying this, the different names for the Earth, now let us study what is the size of the Earth. Okay. The size of the Earth, it is the distribution of land and water bodies. What is it? That is Earth. So here, the Earth is the fifth largest planet in the Sun's family. Sun is a planet or star, children. It is a star. Sun is a star and Earth is a planet. So don't get confusion. So now, as we are learning the size of the Earth, what is the diameter of the Earth? It is 4 times greater than Moon. Can you observe there? You have the 3 pictures. One is Sun, Moon and Earth. So here it is 4 times greater than the Moon and it is around 107 times less than that of the Sun, that is Earth. Earth is a heavenly body. And the total geographical area of the Earth is 510 million square kilometer. So and it is evenly, unevenly distributed, that as we know, it is a distribution of the land and water body here. So, in which 361 million square kilometer, it is covered by water. So, only it is titled as blue planet. 70.78% is covered by water and 149 million square kilometer is covered by land. That is only 29.22%. So when we add 361 plus 149, we get the total geographical area 510 million square kilometers. Okay, children. So now, what the ratio between the land and water body is 1 is to 2, 4 and 3. Okay. Now, after learning this, so here, as I said, the ratio between the land and the water body is 1 is to 2.43. It is unevenly distributed, that is the land body. So, the land and the water body is unevenly distributed, that is 1 is to 2.43. So now let us study the 1:2.43. What is this 1:2? 1:2. 1:2 is nothing but land, and 2.43 is water. So as we know, 70% covered by water and only 30% is by land. So that is the ratio of earth. So now here, the earth, what is the shape of the earth? The shape of the earth is described as geoid. Why it is described? Yes, the earth is, the what is the shape of the earth? The earth shape is often described as geoid, which literally means earth shaped or oblate spheroid. What do you mean by this? Because the earth is flattened at the poles. So we have two poles. That is, can you observe? Here, the earth is flattened to the poles. We had two poles, that is to the top and bottom, north pole and south pole here, and bulge. So here this is bulge. Can you see? It is not exact like ball shape. It is completely flattened to the top and bulged to the equator. So only it is, the earth shape is called geoid. And here, when we measure like a circle, what is a circle circumference? 360. So in this, the earth, the shape of the earth, it is the diameter. The center point refers as 0 degree. Yes, children. So here, can you observe this circle? So this circumference of the circle will be 360 degree. And here, it is divided into two halves, that is to the top and to the bottom. And here we have the center point, that is 0. Here we have the diameter. And here we have the polar and equator. So what's the measurement for the equator? That is 0 degree. So the equatorial circumference, this, it is of 4008 kilometer. And here we have the polar. In the sense, this is the polar circumference. So when we take up to this, here we have 12,714. Can you see here the diameter? And here to the diameter below, to the center, that is to the equator, where we had 12,500. Here to the horizontal diameter, where we had 12,756 kilometers. So when we minus this, so here the polar circumference, we will get it as 42 kilometers as a diameter. And here, as for the regarding the geoid, the shape of the earth. So here, which is a higher here? These or this? So here we didn't get any measurement. So we had to take the minusing to the topper and to the below. That is the equator diameter to this, the vertical diameter and the horizontal diameter. When we minus, we get the circumference for the polar. Okay? So now